Welcome to the lectures on building material, C253. In today's lecture, we will learn about the pig iron. So in today's lecture, we will learn about the pig iron. First of all, we will learn pig iron is a kind of metal. So first of all, we will learn about the metal. What is metal or what types of metal we have? So we have two types of metal. Generally, one is ferrous metal. While another one is non-ferrous metal. Okay. So, what is ferrous metal? They are the metals those that the iron content in them. For the ferrous metal, why the metal those doesn't have the iron content? Those are non-ferrous metals. Means the ferrous metals are the metal which contains iron in them. Non-ferrous metals are the metal which doesn't contain the iron in them. So, as far as our topic is concerned, we are learning about the pig iron. So, this non-ferrous is metal is out of focus. So, if you want to learn about this non-ferrous metal, we will just follow up and concentrate on this the ferrous metal only which contains the iron content in them. Fine. So that we are saying ferrous metal are the metal which has the iron content in them. Fine. So here, further, this ferrous metal is divided into three categories. This ferrous metal is further divided into three categories. What are those? One is the cast iron. Then another one is wrought iron. And then the last one is steel. So this ferrous metal which contains the iron content in it is further divided into three categories, that is cast iron, wrought iron and third one is steel. Fine, we started learning about pig iron. We have said that metal is divided into two parts. One is ferrous metal, another one is non-ferrous metal. Ferrous metal is one which contains the iron. And you said that this ferrous material is further divided into three categories, that is the cast iron, then wrought iron and the steel. So what about, we have not as far as discussed about the pig iron. What is pig iron? You say that. What is pig iron? We are discussing about the ferrous material which contains the iron, and we are discussing about with the three categories of this. And so far we have not discussed about the pig iron. So what is the pig iron? Pig iron is nothing but it is a material which is responsible, which is required for the production of these three. What is pig iron? Pig iron is a material, or it is an iron content, or it is iron material. Pig iron is a material, it is a mineral which is required for the production of these three. What are these three? The cast iron, wrought iron, steel iron. The ferrous material metal is divided into three categories. Those are three, and the pig iron is responsible required for the production of these three. Then the question comes that from where this pig iron came? From where this pig iron came? Because we are seeing the ferrous metal is divided into three categories, these things. And the pig iron is responsible or is required for the production of these three. Then from where the pig iron came? Isn't it? What is the pig iron? The pig iron is nothing but, this pig iron is nothing but, it is crude, impure iron. This pig iron is nothing but, this pig iron is nothing but crude impure iron which is obtained from iron ore. So we are going in reverse direction. See, isn't it? This ferrous metal is divided into three categories, that is the cast iron, wrought iron and steel. And the pig iron is the material or is the metal which is required for the production of these three. And the pig iron is what? The pig iron is nothing but crude impure iron which we generally obtain from the iron ore. So now question comes, what is this iron ore? Isn't it? What is this iron ore? Fine. What is OR? The OR is nothing but this is solid naturally occurring mineral. What is OR? This is nothing but the solid naturally occurring mineral which contains one or more constituents. These we can obtain, these constants or these minerals we can obtain from after applying certain treatment. So what is OR? It is nothing but the solid naturally occurring mineral which contains one or more constituents which we can get after certain treatment. So this is what the OR. So what is iron ore then? We are saying that OR is nothing but this is a solid naturally occurring mineral which contains one or more constituents from where we can get the mineral or these constituents after a certain treatment. So this is OR. So what is the iron ore then? This will also be a solid naturally occurring mineral. What will be iron ore? As far as this is OR only, so what will be iron ore? This is a solid naturally occurring mineral from which we get the iron, that is the iron ore. The ore from where we get the iron. The ore from where we get the iron. That is the iron ore. Means the solid naturally occurring mineral from where we get the iron after certain treatment is called the iron ore. Fine. As we are getting that this will be metal material, this is iron which we are directly getting from the ore, and we are getting the ore from the mines. So this iron ore will be containing so many impurities. So this iron ore will be containing the impurities. What are those impurities? It contains certain impurities. What are those? It can be silica. The iron ore what we get from the direct from the mine, it contains so many types of certain types of impurities. We will list these impurities. These impurities may be in the form of silica, it can be in the form of alumina, it can be in the form of manganese, it can be in the form of manganese oxide. It can be even sulfur, it can be even the phosphorus also. So there are some of the impurities what are generally available in the iron ore. So as they are the impurities, they are the harmful material. So as it is harmful, it will be undesirable material. Fine, these are the harmful material, therefore these are undesirable material. After this, some of the impurities which does not have any value. Some of the impurities which does not have any values are called the gains. Some of the impurities which does not have any values are called the gain. Some of the example, it may be the clay, as they are written directly from the mine. It can be clay, it can be loam, or it can be some kind of sand, or it can be some kind of small pebbles. So what about the impurity which doesn't have any value, which doesn't have any value at all, those impurities are called the gain. G-A-N-G-U-E, those are called the gain. But some of the certain impurities which are generally available in the iron ore are, it can be generally silica, alumina, manganese, manganese oxide, sulfur, phosphorus. They are some of the impurities which are generally available in the or algal. As they are the impurity, these are the harmful material, they are the undesirable material in the ore. Fine. So simply we say that it again, that is if the proportion or the content of N increases within the iron ore, then the iron content reduces, isn't it? If the proportion of N increases within the ore, then the content or the proportion of iron within that ore will reduce, because if this percent or its impurity will increase, because total percent is 100% only, isn't it? The total will be 100% only. If the gain will increase, if suppose this will increase, then definitely this percent has to reduce, because the overall percentage will remain 100 only. So, as we have seen, that's why we say that this gain or these are the impurities which are harmful or the undesirable material. If the proportion of gain increases, then the content of the proportion of iron reduces. Therefore, these are the undesirable material. Even this we are talking in terms of proportion. Right. Second point, that the proportion of iron ore, proportion of iron content this depends upon type of iron ore. The proportion of iron content, the proportion of iron content or the percentage of iron content which what we are getting in ore, it depends upon type of iron ore. Means from iron ore to iron ore, the content or the proportion of iron content varies. Means in one type of iron ore, there we may get some particular percent of iron, while in some other iron ore we can get some other type of iron ore. So from iron ore to iron ore, or to say from ore to ore, the iron content varies. So what are the different types of iron ore? So we have generally 5 types of iron ore from where we can get the iron. What are those? Type of iron. We have said that we have 5 types. We have 5 types of iron ore. What are those? We will list all them. The first one is hematite. Then we have one more, that is magnetite. Then we have pyrite. We have one more, that is the limonite. And we have one more, that is last, that is siderite. So these are some of the types of iron ore from where we can get the iron, that is hematite, magnetite, pyrite, limonite and siderite. This hematite, this is nothing but the Fe2O3, this is the Fe3O4, this is Fe2S. This is, they are some of the iron ore. Out of this magnetite, what we are saying is Fe3O4, this is the richest form of iron ore. As you can see that this is Fe2O3, this is Fe3O4, this is Fe2S, this is Fe3O4, that is this magnetite, this is the richest form of iron ore. The maximum percent of iron we can get from where, generally near about 75% of iron we can get directly from this, near about from this magnetite, that is the Fe3O4. That's why that is the only reason why we say that the magnetite is the richest iron ore. So we have some of the iron ore. So far we have discussed so much introduction about the iron. What is iron? What are different types of metal? Fine. from where we, what is iron ore, what is ore, so from where we get the iron. We have discussed different types of iron ore also, from where we can get the iron content. Now let's come directly on the pig iron. Now what is a pig iron? We have discussed little bit about it. So what we have discussed about the pig iron? This is nothing but the crude impure iron which is obtained from the iron which we get from iron ore, isn't it? It is required or is responsible for the production of your cast iron, then wrought iron, and then for the production of steel. So for these, for the production of these three, it is required pig iron for the production of cast iron, wrought iron, steel. Fine. So this pig iron will be having certain impurities also. Generally, the major impurities are in this sulfur, sulfur and phosphorus. There are among other types of impurities also, but these two, that is the sulfur and phosphorus, is the major type of impurity which is generally available in the pig iron. Fine. After its proportion, we will talk about its proportions also. 92 to 95% is iron content. This is the iron content. Yes, well, the carbon content is almost 3 to 4%. Is the carbon content, remaining is the impurities. Right, they are the proportion. So what it is, pig iron, the production of what pig iron? This is nothing but the crude impure iron, what we get from the iron ore. We have already discussed what is the iron ore. This is nothing but a solid naturally occurring, mineral which from which we get the iron, that is the iron ore, isn't it? This pig iron is required for the production of the cast iron, wrought iron and the steel iron, isn't it? And this pig iron, as we are getting directly from the iron ore, it has certain impurities. The major impurities which are available in this pig iron are sulfur and phosphorus. It has certain proportion. And that is 90 to 95% is the iron content, 3 to 4% is the carbon content, while the remaining are nothing but the impurities which are available in this. Why the third one is smelting. So this is the third step, dressing and dressing of iron ore, calcination and roasting, and smelting. There are three steps of manufacturing the pig iron. So we will discuss first of all the first step, that is dressing. What will be done in this dressing of iron ore? As we are getting this iron ore, we get this iron ore directly from the mines, isn't it? We are getting directly from the mines. So as we are getting it from the mines, these are in the form of big boulders. Dressing of iron ore, as we are seeing that iron ore, which is as far from where we get the big iron, first of all, that is crude. This iron ore taken directly from the mines, so this will be in the form of big boulders, isn't it? As we are getting this iron ore from the mines, it will be in the size of big boulder. We cannot process directly these big boulders. So we have to block them, we have to divide them, we have to crush these big boulders. In the size of generally, we crush them. These big boulders are little back into size of 2.5 cm. So this, after breaking, for this breaking, we can use either crusher with different types of crusher can be used. Generally we prefer the rolling crusher. Generally we prefer the rolling crusher. What it used to be, it used to have two rolls, generally of high steel rollers. One rotates in the clockwise direction while the other one rotates in the anti-clockwise direction. So these two of high steel, these rollers are made up of high steel, where we have the spacing here, while the space which is available in between, here we generally keep the big boulders during rolling. It is divided into the small pieces. So generally we prefer the rolling crusher for the crushing the big boulders, and we generally divide them or break them into a sizes of about 2.5 cm. So once we got the in a size of 2.5 cm, we have obtained after the crushing. So now what to do? As we are saying that these boulders we are getting directly from the mines, it will be having certain impurities. There are certain impurities, we have to remove these impurities. We have to remove these impurities. So what we have to do for this? We have to go for washing. We have to go for washing of the big boulders, that is these broken pieces. We have to go for washing of these things. For washing we have to go for washing. Therefore, you washing we can remove the impurities. Washing, for washing we can use the stream of water. The stream of water can be used for this. By this, what kind of impurity we can remove? The clay, some clay kind of material is available, or some loam. If these kind of impurities are available, then by washing, that is by stream of water, these kind of impurities, that is clay or loam, can be removed from this washing purpose. But yes, suppose we can adopt one more kind of method, that is perforated spray. This perforated spray can also be adopted for the removal of impurities. What kind of impurities can be removed using this perforated spray? Generally, the sand or the pebbles. These kind of impurities can be removed by using this perforated tray. Even after this, we have one more type, that is the magnetic separator. This is first method of removing. This is the second one. It depends on type of impurities are available. If we have only clay or loam, then we cannot go for the washing by this stream of water. If we have this kind of standard pebbles, then we can use the magnetic separator. This is the perforated tray. The third type is the magnetic separator. some kind of impurity is sticky to the ores. If some kind of impurities are sticky to ore, then we generally prefer the magnetic separator, so it will attract the iron ore towards it, so that we can separate from, we can separate the metal from the impurities. So for we generally prefer the magnetic separator. So this is the first step of manufacturing, that is dressing of iron ore. What we are doing, as we are getting directly from the mines in the form of brick molders, we want to break them into the equal sizes. So we generally break them in a size of about 2.5 centimeters. For breaking this, we can use the crushers. Generally, we prefer the rolling crushers. Fine, as we are getting it directly from the mines, it will be having certain impurities in this. So we have to remove the impurities from this material. So what we have certain method, that is we can go either for washing. What is the washing? We can use the stream of water for the washing purposes. In this washing, we can remove the clay or lost type of material. The other way is by using perforated tray, it removes the sand and pebbles. The last one is the magnetic separator. So this is the step one. What is this calcination roasting? This is the heating of material or dressed. Heating of dressed ore in the presence of air is called the calcination. Dressed ore, after what we are getting after the step 1, that is the stone, the heating of that dressed ore in the presence of air. This process is called the calcination. Why we do this calcination? For to oxidize them, to oxidize the ore. What does oxidize mean here? The removal of water and carbon dioxide, that is CO2. Fine. So what we are doing, calcination roasting, the dressed ore, what we are getting direct after the step 1, the heating of that dressed ore in the presence of ore, that is called the calcination. It is done to oxidize the dressed ore, that is to remove the water and carbon dioxide from this material. Then we go for roasting. What is that roasting? This material which is calcinated already, material which is calcinated already is also heated, or to say better, the roasted. This material is further roasted for what? For to remove the sulfur and some volatile material from. So for this purposes, then we go for roasting. So what we are doing here in this calcination and roasting, the whatever dressed ore we got from this step 1, we are going for heating of that material. The heating of this dressed ore in the presence of air is called the calcination. This calcination to oxidize the ore, that is to remove the water and carbon dioxide from it. After the calcination, the material is again roasted for the removal of sulfur and some other kind of volatile material present in it. Then we will describe C, that is nothing but decimality. What we will get? The material which is the dressed or the dressed ore and the calcinated material is melted in the blast furnace. This is what we are doing here, the dressed and calcinated material which we got from the step 1 and step 2. The dressed and calcinated material, whatever we got from the step 1 and step 2, is melted in the blast furnace layer. Is melted in the blast furnace layer. Here, the melted ore is separated out or is separated from this slab. This melted material will be separated from this slab. Fine. So what is the directly we will get the pig iron from here. So what is this melting? This is the process of melting the ore in the blast furnace. This is called as melting. Fine. This is melting. So here we have three steps: dressing of iron ore, calcination, and smelting. What we are doing is melting. The dressed and calcined material is melted in the blast furnace, so that melted material or the melted mass will be separated from the slag. This will be for this will after solidification. This material will be converted into the pig iron. Therefore, this process of melting the calcinated and dressed material in the presence of air in the blast furnace is called this melting. So this is how we get the pig iron. This is the manufacturing process of the pig iron. Now let's discuss the types of pig iron. The pig iron is generally classified based on the presence of carbon content in it. Based on the pig iron is generally classified on the basis of carbon content present in the metal or in the material, that is ore. So based on the carbon content, the pig iron is generally classified. That is, the carbon content which is generally available in the metal is of two forms. It is generally available in the two forms. What are those? One is the combined carbon. What we are saying that the pig iron is generally classified on the basis of carbon content available in it. The carbon content is generally available in two types of form, that is the combined carbon and another one is the free carbon. This free carbon is also known as uncombined carbon. Free carbon used to be dark grey in color. It is dark grey in color. Right. So there are the different types. The trapular pig iron is classified on the basis of carbon content available in it. The carbon is available in two forms, that is combined carbon and the free carbon. The free carbon is also known as uncombined carbon or the graphite. They used to be dark grey in color. Right. This combined carbon makes the metal hard. This makes the metal hard, while this free carbon it makes the metal soft. So this makes the metal soft. So this will result in the stronger metal. This will result in the weaker metal. Fine. This also results in, or this gives the crystalline structure. This gives the crystalline structure to the metal, while this gives the coarse grain structure. So under this, these are the what about of carbon. On the basis of this carbon only, we define or we classify the pig iron into different categories. What we are saying, the carbon is available in the metal in generally two forms, that is combined carbon and free carbon. We have discussed some of the properties of this, that is the combined carbon makes the metal hard. Therefore, these metals will be stronger, as well as it gives the crystalline structure. If the fracture surface will look like a crystalline structure. While this free carbon, which is also known as uncombined carbon or the graphite, it used to be dark gray in color, it makes the metal soft. So these metals will be little bit weaker as compared to the one. It gives the coarse grain structure. So these are some of the properties which will help us in understanding as well as learning the properties or the types of different type of the pig iron. Similarly, on the basis of this carbon content which is present in the metal, the pig iron is generally divided into the six category or the six types. What are those? The number one pig iron, number two pig iron, number three pig iron, number four pig iron, number five pig iron, and the last one is number six pig iron. So on the basis of this carbon content available in the metal, the pig iron is generally divided into six type, or is classified into six type. That is the number one pig iron, number two pig iron, and the last one is number three pig iron, number six pig iron. So we have six, with that we'll learn now. So first of all, we will learn about the number one pig iron. So what property it has, the number one pig iron? This contains almost entirely the free carbon only. It has almost the free carbon only. This number one pig iron, it has almost the free carbon only. So as we are seeing the free carbon, that means it is almost uncombined carbon. They used to be dark gray in color. They are in dark gray in color. As we are saying, they are free carbon. The free carbon makes the metal soft. So it will be, this metal will be very soft. So this number one pig iron is very soft, and hence it is the very weak. It has almost the free carbon only. This number one pig iron has almost free carbon only. So therefore, this used to be dark gray in color. It makes the metal very soft, and hence it is, this metal is very weak. Why? The number two pig iron. This number two pig iron, this is looks almost like, it is almost like number one pig iron only, but the available combined carbon is almost 0.4% in this. It looks almost like number one pig iron only, but the available combined carbon is 0.4% only. This is little bit stronger. It is little bit stronger as compared to number one pig iron. Or this is a little bit hard also, you can say, as it is containing something, the combined carbon, there is no combined carbon, almost it has the free carbon, while it is having about 0.4% combined carbon, so it is little bit stronger or the harder as compared to the number one pig iron. It has certain degree of fluidity also. This is the number 2 pig iron. Right, if you see the number 3 pig iron, then in this number 3 pig iron, the combined carbon is up to 0.6%. This the combined carbon is 0.6%. Here the combined carbon was 0.4% only, but here the combined carbon is 0.6%. But the total carbon percent or total carbon content available in this number 3, this total carbon content available in this is less than the carbon content in number 1 and the total carbon content available in number 2. This point can be remember, we can remember this point. Here the combined carbon has in this, that is 0.6%, but the total combined carbon which is available in this number, the total carbon in this number 3 is less than the total carbon available in number 1 and the total carbon available in number 2. If you take the summation of total carbon available in number 1 and number 2, even though this carbon content will be greater than the total carbon content available in number 3. But the combined carbon is 0.6%, which is greater than number 2 as well as number 1. Because in number 1 the combined carbon is 0% only, because it has almost the free carbon only. So where we can use this? This number 3 pig iron can be used for the foundry works. This can be preferred for the foundry works. Right. Now let's discuss the number 4 pig iron. This number 4 pig iron, the combined carbon is increased up to 0.9%. Here we will have 0.4%, here it was 0.6%, while in this it is 0.9%, up to 0.9% has been increased. It is very strong. As here the combined carbon has increased, this tends to mix, this tends to result in the metal to hard, as well as it makes the crystalline structure. So this combined carbon is almost 0.9%, hence it is very strong material here, as well as this is solely, or to say the alone, sufficient for the manufacturing of the wrought iron. Alone sufficient for the manufacturing of the wrought iron. Then we have number 5 pig iron. What will happen in this? It has the equal proportion of the free carbon as well as the combined carbon. So we will say that 50% combined carbon plus 50% of free carbon. Right. This is also very strong. This can also be used for heavy foundry works. This number 5 pig iron is also known as the mortaic pig iron. This is the number 5 pig iron. Now we will concentrate on the number 6 pig iron. This number 6 pig iron is also known as the white pig iron. It contains sulfur content too much in this. So these are the types of pig iron. So we have discussed the different types of pig iron. What are the number 1 pig iron, number 2 pig iron, number 3 pig iron, number 4 pig iron. Then we have discussed the number 5 pig iron, as well as we have discussed the number 6 pig iron also. Right? So the types of pig iron, this can also be used for the manufacturing of wrought iron. This can also be used for the manufacturing of wrought iron. There are different types. So in today's lecture we have learned what is metal, two types of metal we have. In this we have learned, then we have learned about the ferrous metal as well as non-ferrous material, then we learned about ore. Then we learned about the iron ore, its different types. Then we learned about the pig iron, what is pig iron, different contents, different impurities available in that. Then the manufacturing of pig iron we learned, as well as we have seen the different types of pig iron. That is number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5 and number 6. So this is all about today's lecture, that is pig iron. Thank you.